Charger. Macmillan, tell me about the dark sky.
Okay, thank you. Well, here in Mayo, we are lucky enough to have Ireland's only dark sky park. It's an international designation, and it's awarded by the Dark Sky Association in America.
Mm-hmm.
We got this award in 2016 for the quality of the night skies over the area of Ballycroy and Wildnathan, which is completely free from light pollution. And so what we're doing as a community group, we're all volunteers, is we're just trying to raise awareness of the impact of light pollution on our daily lives. As a species, we've evolved to a night and day circadian rhythm, our biological clock. And the issue with light pollution is that that interferes with our, our sleep patterns and our ecology and well-being. So we're not anti-light at all, we're just trying to encourage people and local authorities to use the right amount of light at the right place, at the right time. And also to encourage people not to use blue-rich lighting, to opt for warm-coloured, if it's LEDs they're opting for, to opt for warm, rich colours that are of the colour tone of 3000 Kelvin. That's our benchmark or below.
And in ordinary men's language, what would a blue-rich, what do you call it?
Blue-rich.
Blue-rich lighter.
So
where would you find it?
So blue rich LED lightings are typically the ones that we're starting to see now as street lights. They're extremely white. We don't see them as blue. We see our eyes see them as white, very bright, harsh almost lighting. So that actually interferes with circadian rhythms. It's almost recreating daylight at night. And already 18% of our population uses our colour vision at night, which as a species we shouldn't be doing. We have night vision and we have evolved to do that. So we're just trying to advise people, if we can, to use warmer lighting, to only use lighting that's going downwards, that's aimed down, and to only light the area required and not to let it spill out or up into other places where it's not needed or not necessary.
And is there much light pollution around?
Light pollution, unfortunately, is a growing issue. Yes, it's usually through lights that are either installed incorrectly or excessive light that's installed, purely because it's available. So the lighting industry has provided us with, I suppose, fantastic developments in lighting, but also they are a little bit excessive in some cases for our daily needs for security purposes.
And how is the Ballycroy area doing now?
In Ballycroy and Wildnathan, so the national park, it is excellent. We had a gold tier standard award. The communities around Ballycroy and Wildnathan, so Newport, Mulranny and Ballycroy, are all working together to improve their lighting. And as we say, we're not telling people not to light, we're just asking them to use downward directed lighting and warm coloured lighting.
And is there much public interest in this?
There's a growing interest. Our festival, Mayo Dark Sky Festival, started 3 years ago, and we now have three communities involved. We have international speakers coming over. We have a great interest. We have upwards of 300 people attending this weekend event in November, between the 2nd and 4th of November. And you can find out all the information on mayodarkskyfestival.ie.
And you fill the cinema here today?
We have. This is the second time we've been in Westport, and we've upgraded now to Screen 2, and we've managed to fill that for our event on the Night Sky Heritage with Derek Dempsey of the Newport Astronomy Club. And hopefully we'll be back again to tell you more in the Screen 3.